left side, hey guys.
Definitely in the air. Temperatures expected to be in the 40s tonight. Yikes, as we get set for this edition of Major League Baseball presented by the show. We've got a good one on tap here, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the Toronto Blue Jays. Hello again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian here to take you through this one. With me, as always, are former big leaguers Dave Campbell and Eric Karros. And, Soup, you've been at this a long time now. What catches your eye when we look at a matchup like this?
Well, the first thing I always do when I come to the ballpark is check out the pitching matchup, and we have a stellar one here. Both of these guys are capable of working deep into the ballgame, so it's possible the team that knocks the other starter out first will come out victorious. Let's see if that plays itself out.
All right, Dave, and we'll get to Eric in just a minute, but now let's take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Tampa Bay Rays, brought to us by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Upton. Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd.
First pitch.
706. Pitch on the way. Here's one hit towards the hole. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. And before we go too much farther tonight, let's call upon our comparison graphic to show you how these two combatants match up with one another offensively. And here's a fastball called for strike one. The mercury has dipped under 50, 49 degrees here at first pitch. On a swing, and he popped him up off to the left in foul territory. There to take it is Bautista, and he's got it for out number two. Our umpiring crew for tonight's game, Woody Keller calls the balls and strikes. The old Irishman, Porter Callahan's over at first. Dutch Nelson, the crew chief, will be out at second. And Joe Watson will be the arbiter down at third. Now a ball pulled hard but foul off to the left. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. And this is caught off of the plate as it's chopped foul. Hit high but foul as that'll get in amongst the fans. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. So a relatively routine start for the top of the first here. Tampa Bay nothing. Blue Jays due up next. Major League Baseball is on the show. We'll jump forward in this one to the top of inning number two. Dan Johnson leads things off now in the top half of the second. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And early on, you can see him trying to jam guys with that pitch, not let them get extended.
And this one's in the air now for Patterson out in center. One gone. And with one away, time for a check of the standings in the American League East as you get a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play. John Jaso is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. No score here as we play inning number two. Now the fastball here is swung on and grounded foul. And this will be lined into center field, and they've got themselves their first hit of the ball game.
And this is something they've worked on in the batting cages, taking some of the movement out of his swing. Much more compact now, and he's seeing some definite results.
Reed Brignac will come forward now, back in the lineup after being used as a pinch hitter last night. And a fastball close, but ultimately ruled a ball. Not enough, but a foul ball, 1-1. Runner at first here, one man out. And a slider misses here, two balls and a strike.
Trying to backdoor him, but it stays outside just a bit.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. And he missed with this one up around the noggin. Now it's full.
Let's see now if they're going to want to think about putting something on here.
Off-speed pitch, and there is strike three called. And boy, that zone just got a bit larger, two away.
And anytime a catcher has to reach that far to get it, that ball's usually off the corner. I think they caught a break there.
Ben Zobrist will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. Too low, 1-0. A runner on first with two away. And he misses again, 2-0.
And let's see if he makes him throw a strike here.
The 2-0. Now here's a check swing. Did he go around is the question. And yes, he did, says the man in blue. Strike one. Inside for the ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1. Out in front as he yanks this down the line at first. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. And makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. The 3-2 one more time. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Rays strand just the one. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no scoring. Number 5 will stand in, hoping to turn things around from the loss last night. He was 0-for-4 in that ball game. And a good fastball there, but this just misses the zone for ball one. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
And here's where it helps to have your good hands people in the middle of the diamond to handle hot shots like that. Those one-hoppers can sometimes have a tendency to skip on you, but he stayed right with that one nicely.
Kelly Shopik is at the plate as he looks at ball one. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1.
And you get the sense that both of these teams are just sort of feeling out the opposition here the first time through.
No contact there, and it's 1-2. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes, so it's 2 up, 2 down to begin the third.
Boy, and this guy's been every bit as good as advertised so far. He's looking like he definitely belongs up here.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And standing in, the speedy center fielder, B.J. Upton. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Swing, hard hit ball to second. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So nothing happening this time around. We'll head now to the home half of inning number 3. And we are tied nothing-nothing. Number 80 will step in. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Now a hard liner, but foul. swing and a hard liner to center field. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. Evan Longoria will dig in, 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
That was a dangerous spot there for a good fastball hitter. Good thing he was taken.
Swing and, ooh, he saws him off with that one. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. And a half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
And this is one of the downsides of having strength at the plate. Once you start, it's hard to stop, and he winds up going around for strike three.
Dan Johnson will stand in.
Dan Johnson.
Now a bluff here as he steps off to looking back at first. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Working the inside corner with the fastball. Let's see if they stay right there.
And he lays off for ball one. From the belt, the pitch. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Late swing and a ball line fouled into the seats past the third base dugout. Ready with another 2-2. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2.
And now on 3-2, let's see if he gets a fastball here.
And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two-strike pitch and chops it foul. Runners on the move for second. And there's a changeup that's pulled toward right center field. Therefore, it is DeJesus, two away.
Now, we're still looking for that first run of the ballgame. Thought for a second this might be it, but it just didn't have enough steam behind it.
John Jaso will take his cuts now. Now here's the first pitch. Swings under this one as he pops it high in the air toward the right side. Kelly is there and the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. Reed Brignac will dig in. 0 for 1 here in this one. There's that circle change of his, but it's outside for ball one.
And he's just two over the minimum here in his fifth inning of work, so they've yet to get a sustained rally going against him.
Bautista is there, and he has it for the out. So one gone in the inning, and that'll bring up Ben Zobrist. And they'll go the other way with the fastball as this is on the ground to third. On to first, and there were two down. Number 5 will step in. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And here's another first pitch strike, and he's just running roughshod right through this lineup.
Well, they just have not put up much of a fight. I totally agree. He's had his way out there from the word go.
1-1 pitch on the way. And this is fouled back and out of play. On the ground towards second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Kelly Shopik will dig in. 0 for 1 in the ballgame. And we look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one.
And sometimes mixing it up means going right back to the same pitch and the same location. Hitters often think you'll be trying something different.
And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. Swung on and popped sky high to the right side of the infield. There to play it is Lind, and there's one away. Leadoff man retired in the inning for B.J. Upton. And a fastball misses here to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Ball two. No runs, two hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And a swing here on 2-0 as this is in the air out to straightaway center. Patterson is there now, and he has it, two gone.
Yeah, it looked like this might be much more off the bat, but this ballpark has really played large tonight, and you know, we've seen a few balls right now really get knocked down out there.
Number 80 will dig in, 1-2 thus far. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Here it comes. Missed low and inside with it, 1-1.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup, so you can't let your guard down.
And Bautista will make the catch to retire the side. So another good inning for him on the mound. Six shutout innings now. Evan Longoria will lead it off here in the top of inning number 7. Now the first pitch. Now here's a fastball at the knees, and that location has paid off for him so far. It's 0-1.
Well, you're absolutely right. I mean, in general, the more you can work in that lower half of the zone, the more success you're going to have.
Swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
And these last few pitches have all been down, which is not a bad idea against a guy like this.
1-2 pitches swung on and lifted in the air out to center field. Patterson is right there, one down. Dan Johnson will stand in 0-2 in the ballgame so far. And this pitch is hit rather sharply toward the third base coaching box. It's a foul ball. And some action now in the Toronto bullpen as a right-hander starts to get loose. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Here's the pitch. Spins and pulls this one down the line at first. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. John Jasoff will be the batter, 1-2 thus far. Now here's the first pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Swinging a ground ball towards the middle. A few steps to his left is Drew. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So he keeps rolling right along. Make it 7 shutout innings now. We'll look ahead now and pick this one back up in the top of inning number 8. Reed Brignac will get us going now in the top half of the 8th. Fastball swung on and lifted out to center field for Patterson. And he puts it away for the first down. Our line score there says it all to this point, or if you prefer, it doesn't say anything. Nothing our score as we start to wonder if anyone's going to play to run in this one. And it gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. And he's right on the fastball there as this is hit pretty well out towards deep left. Marte is going to have room, though, as he backs up to put it away, and there are two men gone. number 5. We'll dig in, 0 for 2 thus far. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one.
And something you rarely see in this day and age, both of these bullpens have had the night off so far.
Swinging a hard hit ball back up the middle. And this is past the shortstop Drew for a base hit. Manuel Ramirez will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Manny Ramirez.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Boy, and any time you can turn to a guy with double-digit home runs on your bench, now that's a luxury to have.
Runners going. Patterson is back to the track, though, as he pulls it in, and a sigh of relief as the side is retired. And we'll move forward now to the top of inning number 9. B.J. Upton will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0 for 3 thus far, and that misses inside 1-0.
And this is a guy that can run into one every now and then, so he can't be taken lightly, especially in only a one-run game.
And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees. Swinging a ground ball to first. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
And this has been an important start for these guys because late in the season, it's always a plus to give your bullpen a break whenever you can.
Now a fastball to start things out. Didn't miss by a lot, but it's 1-0. And it runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
And in a close ball game, I think you let him throw you one here.
Opposite field to left, in there, the base hit.
As we forge through this final month of the season, he's making a real push to end the year over 300. He's got a solid base hit here.
Carlos Villanueva, come on now as he'll try to record the final two outs here. Just about do it. For Dave Campbell, Eric Carroll, and our entire San Diego-based crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian saying thanks for joining us here tonight. This has been a presentation of MLB 11, The Show. For more...